Friends, family, I welcome you to this great celebration. Today, before the church, before God's people, Erica and Jonathan will give themselves to each other. And as I welcome you, I ask you to pray for them. Today, the sacrament of marriage begins. So, Erica and Jonathan, the church shares your joy. And warmly I welcome you, together with your family and friends. In the presence of God, our Father, you will establish between yourselves a lifelong partnership. May the Lord hear your prayer on this joyful day, and may he send you help from heaven and protect you. May he grant you your heart desires and fulfill every one of your prayers. We give thanks to God as we recite the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. But none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man. And while he was asleep, he took one of the ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he had brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone to my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, put on as God's chosen one, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bearing with one another, and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these, put on love, that is, the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, and the peace into which you were also called in one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, sing songs, hymns, and spiritual songs, with gratitude in your hearts to God. In whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, the Father, through him, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My friends, the Lord be with you. The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made a male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human must separate. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please, you will be seated. I should have done this at the beginning of the Mass, but I guess I was too excited. For many of you who may not know me, my name is Father Peter Bassi. I was assigned here to serve for 3 years after my seminary formation at Christ the King Seminary. And I was recently reassigned to St. Mary's and St. John in Olean. So for these two, I would travel anywhere to celebrate your wedding. So I'm so happy to be here today to be part of this amazing celebration. These two mean a lot to me. And you know, on a day like this, my typical self, I will always throw some jokes and stories around. So I remember one of the jokes one of my professors at the seminary shared with us. I'm not sure if he was the one that went through the experience or if it was someone else. So, he said, a priest was getting ready for weekend Mass. And he was getting ready for Mass, thinking about what he was going to preach to the people of God. And while he was thinking about what to preach to the people of God, and taking his time in the shower and shaving his face, he mistakenly cut his face. And well, he's done taking his shower and bandaged his face and showed up to Mass and tell the people what happened to him while he was taking his time, thinking about his homily, what he was going to preach. He mistakenly cut his face. And he went on to preach 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 25. The people were exhausted. They were waiting for when he would be done. And now he was done after maybe 25 something minutes. And after Mass, one of his friends went over and said to him, "Father, I'm so sorry about what happened to you, but how about next time you think about your face and you cut your homily?" So, I would love to go on and on and on and on during this amazing celebration. But friends, today is not the day for me to show I'm good at preaching or to show I know how to synthesize the Word of God. But it's the day for us to celebrate Erica and Jonathan and to pray the Lord Jesus, who brought them together, to sustain them and be with them always. And the readings you guys chose for this Mass completely represent who you are. Getting to know you two and getting to know how you relate to each other, it makes sense that all of us were gathered here today. And the reading from Genesis, God created everything, Adam and Eve, all the animals, and gave Adam the power to name animals. And what is happening in this reading? It's theology meeting anthropology. Anthropology in the sense that the basic human desire, the needs, Adam saw all the animals that came forward and he named them. None of them was compatible to him. None of them was compatible in intellect. None of them was compatible in intimacy. None of them was compatible to provide emotional need and also receive. And God did what? He took from Adam one rib and did what? He made Eve. And when he saw Eve, yes, this is the one. The bone of my bone, the flesh of my flesh. I believe when you were born, God took your rib also and put it somewhere for the special woman whom today becomes Erica. You see, God is very intelligent in so many ways, so many ways. You see, God did not take the rib from Adam, he did not take from the head, so that the woman will be working on, or the woman will be working on Adam also. He did not take the rib from beneath his foot so that the woman will be working on. She would not have equal say in the relationship. God took the rib from the side so that both they would be equal. They share the same mutual love. And he took the rib from the side, close to the heart, so that she would be loved and cherished. So, you see the smartness of God in all of his creative work. And now, when you do join your life together, in a way, you also continue this creative work of God, which will be exemplified in the gift of children, and perhaps grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren also. So as we share, as we rejoice with you, we ask you, today is a day of marriage. Your wedding ends today. But the school of marriage is forever. And that's when you have to draw closer to God. Draw closer to your family. Draw closer to your friends. So I'm going to leave you a very practical image in your mind when you think about this day. So help me, what shape is this? Come on, help me. What shape is this? Triangle. So what shape is this? Triangle. See, the love relationship you have with each other, it's down here at the vertical level. And the love and the compassion has to lead you to the horizontal, which is God himself. So you're now drawn into the Trinity that exemplifies love itself also. So whatever you're doing, always know the Lord Jesus, he is with you. He strengthens all of you. He supports you with his grace. Have one more. What shape is this? A circle or a donut, right? Yeah, that would be nice. This is an unbroken line. What is happening is you have circled yourself with the love of God first, the love of your parents who are down here in this church, your friends, and especially yourself. Just like the circle is not broken, do not allow the stresses of life, the difficulties that would come, to break this relationship God will solidify today. Because when we're done today, the school of marriage begins. And when things are thrown at you guys in the world, when the society redefines so many things, how do you navigate all of this? Love, prayer, and the relationship you share with your family. So, one thing in common all of us we have at this mass is this duty to pray for them, long-lasting relationship. May the good Lord, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to completion. And with that, it's time. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of God so that in the presence of the church minister and the community gathered here, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you together. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, so that you may be faithful to each other and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Erica and Jonathan, have you come into the house of God without force, freely and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared as you follow the path of marriage to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the church and Christ's law?
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter into the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His church. I, Erica, take you, Jonathan, to be my husband.
I, Erica, take you, Jonathan, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to honor you.
To love and to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Jonathan, take you, Erica, to be my wife.
I, Jonathan, take you, Erica, to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in good health.
In sickness and in good health.
To love and to honor you all the days of my life.
To love and to honor you all the days of my life.
May the Lord in His kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment His blessing within you. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. We shall now bless the ring which both will extend to each other. May the Lord bless these rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity. Amen. Erica, receive this ring.
Erica, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of your Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Jonathan, receive this ring.
Jonathan, receive this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
We shall now invite all of you to please stand as Christoph Michael leads us in the prayers.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us accompany this new family with our prayers, that the mutual love of this couple may grow daily, and that God in His kindness will sustain all families throughout. for this bride and groom, for their well-being as a family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their relatives and friends, for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our families who have passed from this world, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst, Lord Jesus, who are present in our midst, as Jonathan and Erica seal their union, accept our prayer, and will fill us with your Spirit, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
We bring all our prayers on behalf of Erica and Jonathan. We ask you to accompany them, and bless their families. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please go be seated.
Blood.
power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he sent a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat the bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the blessing of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have given for your good. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Strengthen, we pray, in the grace of marriage, Erica and Jonathan, whom you have brought happily to their wedding day, that under your protection they may always be fruitful in their lives. To the covenant they have sealed in your presence, in your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give an admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O
stand.
At the sacred command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these his servants, now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of them one heart in love by the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, those he has joined by a holy matrimony. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your image, making the woman an inseparable to the man, that they might be no longer two, but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who created the bond of marriage by so great a mystery that in the wedding covenant foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church be fortified. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning is endowed with one blessing, not forfeited by original sin, nor washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit, and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace and love and peace abide in your daughter, Erica, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and your covenant and commandment, made one in flesh. May they be blameless in all they do, and with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children, and grant that, reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they long, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now extend to each other the sign of Christ's peace. to celebrate these two beautiful people. Thank you so much for being part of this amazing celebration, and to honor Erica and Jonathan and also friends of the family. And thank you so much for being here. Your presence alone shows me that these two, they are on the right path. And just knowing them, I look forward to celebrating with them 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. You better find me, because I'll find you. May the God, Eternal Father, keep you in one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide with you always. Amen. May you be blessed in your children and have solace in your friends and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and the needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into eternal dwelling of God. So, with the power given to me by the state of New York and the church, I declare peace to Mr. and Mrs. Sikowski.
Sikowski.
Are you done?
No. I have been practicing that last name since last night. When I was playing tennis this morning, Sikowski? Sikowski? Which one? So, I'm sorry, Eric.
Jonathan.
But I'm so happy for you too. May the Lord, in his love and blessing, be with you. And may the Almighty God bless all of you gathered here in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. And I forgot to thank our little flower girls here. Thank you, guys. You did amazing.
So now what?
You turn around. Because I know. My dress.
Thank you.
I'm Stan the Bride's father. On behalf of Erica, Jonathan, the newlyweds, Jonathan's mother Sue, and Erica's mother Rose, and myself, I'd like to welcome everyone to this joyous occasion. Preparing for this day has been very stressful for Jonathan and Erica due to COVID-19 and not knowing what restrictions would be in place on their wedding day. COVID has also caused wedding expenses to increase substantially. With Erica being my only daughter, no expense was spared, and because of this, I will need to replenish my retirement fund. There will be a jar at the exit marked Stan's Retirement Fund as you leave today. Don't be bashful in contributing. Cash, checks, and Venmo are acceptable. For dinner, we are having chicken cordon bleu and filet mignon. Make sure you finish everything on your plate. You can then burn it off by dancing the night away. Okay. As some of you may know, Erica was a difficult child from the day she was born. Erica put her mother through hell when she was delivered. I was in the delivery room when Erica was born with the umbilical cord wrapped around her neck. She was purple in color and not breathing. Rose and I were informed by the doctor that she was without oxygen for a short period of time and that her left arm was paralyzed. She was placed in the nursery ICU for several days for observation. Excuse me. I got to flip the page. Here we go. After she was released from the hospital, Erica was able to move her arm and went on, as she grew up, to participate in dance, gymnastics, and field hockey. Erica enjoys sports, and we spend father-daughter time attending the Bills games, which is like 10 minutes from our house. Erica is very independent, and she knows what she wants. Her experience with going to Ohio State her first year of college set the stage for her independence from her parents. When she was thinking about changing her major at Ohio State, I suggested she come home and go to UB, which at first she was reluctant to do. She got to like UB, graduated with a bachelor's degree in political science, and went on to graduate from UB Law School. Rose and I, thank you. Rose and I are amazed at what she has been able to accomplish after having come into the world under such difficult circumstances. Of course, there are times during Erica's high school years when she and her girlfriends were mischievous. We live adjacent to ECC South parking lot used by the fans during the Bills home games. Erica and her girlfriends would go out of her bedroom window to the parking lot and gather up beer and bring them back to the house and leave them outside her bedroom window. Of course, they would drink it. Rose and I were not aware of this until sometime quite after that. On one occasion, we wouldn't allow Erica to go out with her friends, and she became very upset. A short time later, the doorbell rang, and two police officers were inquiring about a 9/11 call that was made about a hostage situation. Just kidding. Erica called 9/11 by mistake when she was trying to call a friend. However, one morning around 5 a.m., Rose and I received a call from the state troopers in Cheektowaga to come and pick up Erica and her three partners in crime from the barracks. When we arrived, we saw the four of them sitting on a bench having a grand old time talking and laughing. And three of those partners in crime are sitting right here. The trooper was disturbed to see them taking this so lightly. Then there's Jonathan. It all began on December 2014 with Jonathan stopping over to visit and then leaving to go home. It progressed to Jonathan stopping over to visit and staying overnight. From there, it progressed to Erica making Jonathan breakfast in bed. She never made me breakfast in bed. Erica had gone out with other guys, but you knew this was serious with Jonathan. In December of 2018, Jonathan and Erica moved into the house they bought. Although this was somewhat of a sad occasion for Rose and I, with them moving out, The great part about it was that my household expenses went down by over 50%. Jonathan, could you stand up for a minute? Just looking at him, you wouldn't think he eats like a horse. Now you can sit down. That was it. Rose's brother Dan and his neighbors had a party about 4 years ago. At that party, a group of law enforcement guys would call together a meeting, at which time they could partake in a shot of this concoction that they created. Several of us participated in the meetings, including Jonathan. After several shots, you got a real buzz. Jonathan had never addressed me as Mr. Gasowitz or Mr. G, as Erica's friends would do. On this day, Jonathan became brave and blurted out, "Hey, Stan, now we're best buds." I don't know if Jonathan has a dark side because I haven't seen it. If Jonathan has a dark side and it shows its ugly head, and if I'm not around, Jonathan will have to contend with Erica's brother, Brandon, who's sitting second from the end there, or her three uncles, Joe, George, and Dan, they're sitting over at that table. Jonathan, remember, Erica is half Italian, and you know what could happen if you get on the wrong side of an Italian. When Jonathan came to our house about a year ago to ask Rose and I if it was okay with us if he asked Erica to marry him, my first response to him was, "I don't think so." And that's what I did say to him. I don't know if he was shocked or what. If someone were to have asked me who I would like Erica to marry, I would not hesitate to reply, "Jonathan." Just give me a minute here. There's not much more to talk about.
Do you know?
There you go. Thank you. Jonathan, Rose, and I are very pleased to have you as our son-in-law. I'd like to formally welcome you into our family. I hope you and Erica have many happy years together. We both love you. Cheers to the happy couple. Here we go.
For those of you who don't know me, my name's Cassandra. I'm Erica's best friend, maid of honor. Our story begins back in the first grade. We were in the same class and a friendship was made. At 6 years old, we both gave Girls Club a spin and solidified being best friends with this butterfly pin. We have grown up together through middle school, high school, even college too. We barely caused any trouble, despite what our parents tell you. Erica, you are such a stunning bride. I truly am so lucky to be here by your side. You are beautiful, kind, thoughtful, caring, and smart. I think every person here can agree you have the biggest heart. Now let's travel back to 2014. That's where this love story begins, when John met his queen. They met in John's sister's basement, then went out to the bar. Now, 7 years later, look where you are. John, thank you for loving Erica as much as I do. If there's anyone I have to share her with, I'm so glad that it's you. You two are a picture-perfect couple, both with hearts of gold. I know you'll continue to love each other, even when you're gray and old. May you always have love and laughter in your home every day. And may you live long and healthy lives as partners in every way. John, please take good care of Erica. Don't let her coffee mug addiction drain your pockets. And Erica, for the love of God, please keep John away from bottle rockets. It's a little bit sad to feel like you're giving your best friend away, but I know you'll both be there for me at the end of the day. So let's make a toast for John making Erica his wife. John, you are now stuck with both of us for the rest of your life.
How's it going, everybody? All right, where is that thing? I think I threw it in my pocket. Just kidding. I got a backup on a backup. Hello, everyone. My name is Dane, and as the best-looking one in the group, I am honored to be John's best man. For those of you who don't know me yet, I would like to apologize in advance. I would first like to thank everyone for joining us and celebrating John and Erica on their special day. Thanks to the parents of the newlyweds, the wedding parties, and everyone else who made this day perfect for John and Erica. John and I met 17 years ago when I moved into his neighborhood. John was the cool kid doing tricks on his skateboard, and I was the kid riding around on an electric scooter. Even after that embarrassing encounter, our friendship continued to grow. We played soccer together. We've lived together. He has been the best friend I could ever ask for. Erica. You look absolutely stunning. Give it up for her. You are the strong, independent woman John has been searching for. And I am thrilled for the both of you. John, I know your dad would be very proud of you and the decisions you've made, especially today. So I asked Erica what little things John does around the house that drives her absolutely crazy. But the list was overwhelming. With that in mind, John, I will end on a little quote that may help you in the future. Happy wife, happy life. Please join me in raising a glass to John and Erica. May they make the most beautiful blonde babies.
Our place, we make rules. And there's a dazzling haze, a mysterious way about you. Have I known you 20 seconds or 20 years? Can I go away? Can we always be this close? But ever and ever and I, take me out and take me home. You're my, 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 my lover. Could let our friends crash in the living room. This is our place, we make the call. And I'm highly suspicious that everyone who sees you wants you. I've loved you 3 summers now, honey,
but I want them all. Can I go where you go? Can we always be this close forever and ever? I take me out and take me home. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute. Oh, I never thought true love would be making one as lovely as she. But isn't she lovely, Mabel? Isn't she pretty? Truly the angel best. For I'm so happy we have been heaven blessed. I can't believe what God has done. Through us he's given life to one. But isn't she lovely, Nibana?
Child.